South Korea is launching a high-speed train service that will reduce the travel time between central Seoul and its outskirts. So, how is it going to improve the birth rate in the country? To answer this question, let's get some context.
Women no longer agree with the distinction of men at work and women at home. Women think they should participate in society and work, so they choose work rather than marrying and having children.
Since 2013, South Korea has grappled with the world's lowest fertility rate, standing at a mere 0.78%. Experts suggest it may take years to reach the 2.1% rate necessary for population stability without relying on migration. To combat this decline, the Korean government has pinned hopes on their underground high-speed train initiative. A report from South Korea's central bank sheds light on the underlying issues, pointing to employment struggles, housing difficulties, which have continuously been on the rise compared to people's earnings, and childcare challenges as key contributors to the country's declining birth rate.
Up until June, I was still looking for a job, but I couldn't find one I liked. So I started to volunteer at a youth solidarity bank.
These factors underscore the human side of the fertility crisis, highlighting the real-life obstacles facing families as they navigate decisions about their futures. Here's how the Great Train Express can help with increased childbirth. In South Korea, where long commutes and expensive housing make life tough, a new solution is on the horizon. The Great Train Express, GTX, is projected to solve the dwindling birth rate problem of the country. But how did the country get to this stage, and what makes the GTX so special? Well, that's exactly what this episode is all about. The Korean work culture is often compared with the military culture.
Some Korean companies tend to have this military environment, military type of culture where you have to always say yes to the boss.
And that goes for whatever the boss is requesting.
The reason is the nature of the work ethic. The strict ranks, respect, status, etc., can be tiring on many levels. So they tend to work long hours. About 40 hours per week is the basic full-time workload, and then 12 hours per week of overtime is allowed.
And the world's paying attention to a Korean culture of death by overwork.
In contrast, an average American works 38.7 hours per week with a more accessible transportation system. Long commutes in South Korea, about 101 minutes per day, eat into family time, leaving little room for quality moments together. Couples facing hours of travel daily find it challenging to juggle work and family life. This imbalance strains relationships and discourages starting or expanding families. Inadequate time spent together reduces opportunities for intimacy and bonding, contributing to a decline in fertility rates. The stress and exhaustion from lengthy commutes further compound these issues, creating a challenging environment for couples to envision raising children amidst the hustle and bustle of urban life.
For Albert On, it's a project nearly 6 years in the making, proposed as part of Pyeongchang's Olympic promise to invest roughly $13 billion in infrastructure. The Korea Train Express, or KTX, serves as an important pipeline, shuttling nearly 21,000 passengers from Incheon Airport to Olympic venues every day.
South Korea's rail system has been lauded for its efficiency, especially in major cities like Seoul. With buses, subways, and above-ground trains, it offers extensive coverage. However, the system faces a significant challenge. While fast, it doesn't reach far enough into the suburbs, where housing is more affordable. This creates a dilemma for couples. Living closer to work means smaller, pricier homes, while cheaper options require long commutes. These extended travel times eat into family time, discouraging couples from having children.
조그만 아이들은 너무 귀여워요. 아이들의 귀여운 모습을 보면 낳고 싶다가도 어떻게 교육을 해야 되는지 그거를 이제 가르친 사교육계 입장으로서는 너무 원산이다.
South Korea's GTX is a $99.5 billion mega rail project, a visionary solution to the country's pressing urban and demographic challenges.
The Great Train Express began partial operation over the weekend, and it's now available for workers to commute from the Greater Seoul region to Seoul in under 30 minutes.
This super-fast underground bullet train offers unparalleled speed and connectivity, promising to revolutionize commuting in South Korea. Its creation stemmed from a need to address similar problems faced by other countries, leading South Korea to seek a bolder solution. By investing in a high-speed underground train network, the government hopes to make suburban living more appealing. With speeds of up to 180 kilometers per hour, the GTX drastically reduces commute times, offering a viable solution for couples seeking larger, more affordable homes outside urban centers. By addressing the root cause of the fertility decline, long commutes and limited family time,
the GTX will allow people from far places to commute more conveniently, and I think I can also consider a job flipping to other regions as well.
The GTX seeks to incentivize family formation and reverse South Korea's declining birth rate trend. The GTX holds immense promise as a transformative solution to South Korea's urban and demographic challenges. By offering fast, reliable, and convenient transportation between Seoul and its suburbs, the GTX aims to redefine the dynamics of urban living. It has the potential to alleviate urban congestion and housing pressures in Seoul, incentivizing young couples to consider suburban living where larger and more affordable housing options are available. While the GTX offers significant benefits, it may not be able to completely solve all challenges. Rising housing costs could eventually negate the time savings gained from shorter commutes, presenting a potential obstacle to achieving its full potential. The GTX boasts several special features that set it apart from traditional transportation systems. With wider seats, smoother acceleration, and high-tech features for a stress-free journey, the GTX aims to provide commuters with a comfortable and efficient mode of transportation. South Korea isn't new to the challenge of a declining birth rate. The government has tried numerous solutions to tackle this problem, with varying success. The government has offered cash bonuses for having babies, a quick fix, but it hasn't solved the deeper issues. Subsidies to cover childbirth costs, childcare, and education expenses help, but long term, they're not enough. Surprisingly, the government now offers parents of newborns a monthly allowance of $750 until their child reaches 1 year old. Previously, this amount was $520, but was increased to $750 in early 2024. Extended parental leave, up to 12 months, and flexible work options are important, but they face resistance in a work culture that often expects very long hours and face time at the office. Public campaigns try to promote the importance of family life and change attitudes towards parenthood. But if the cost of living and long commutes remain the problem, these campaigns fall on deaf ears. Despite these well-intentioned efforts, South Korea's birth rate hasn't budged enough. This shows that complex problems need bold, multifaceted solutions. The GTX isn't about replacing those policies, it's about tackling the core problem that makes those other solutions less effective. A continued low birth rate in South Korea can be dangerous, both financially and socially. Fewer workers mean a shrinking tax. This will cripple government programs like pensions. Also, there may not be enough revenue to support the needs of a growing elderly population. When it comes to social impact, the fabric of communities weakens. Schools close, businesses struggle to find employees, and overall innovation suffers. A nation's spirit can dwindle as its population shrinks, leading to a sense of stagnation and decline. The GTX, it's a bold social experiment. By bridging the gap between city and suburb, it seeks to offer families larger, more affordable homes without sacrificing precious time spent together. It challenges traditional notions of urban living and encourages a shift towards more family-friendly environments. Time is a valuable commodity, particularly for young couples juggling work and family responsibilities. The GTX promises to give families back precious hours otherwise lost to long commutes, enabling them to enjoy more quality time together and pursue personal interests. South Korea's birth rate crisis demands decisive action. the government recognizes the urgency of the situation and views the GTX as a necessary leap of faith. Its success or failure will send a clear message about the country's commitment to addressing demographic challenges and shaping its future. The success of the GTX hinges on its ability to lure enough people from Seoul to suburban areas and encourage workplaces to adopt more flexible policies. South Korea's struggle isn't unique. Many developed nations face similar challenges with aging populations and shrinking workforces. The GTX, if it succeeds, could be a blueprint for others, proof that fast, reliable transport can play a vital role in solving a global problem. The Great Train Express isn't just about faster commutes, it's a symbol of hope for a nation facing a demographic crisis. Can a train help change the destiny of an entire country? South Korea is betting its future on it.